So when we start thinking about strokes and heart attacks and peripheral vascular disease, those things aren't different diseases. Mm-hmm. They're different manifestations of the same disease. So what we've done in America is we've made the American public think they have all these different things and that we have different things that we want to do for you for those things. But it's not. It's one thing. And the source of all of these things come back to what we eat. And so we take lots of pills for cholesterol control. And yes, everybody does make cholesterol. Some people make more than others. But most people, their bad cholesterol, they're getting from the only places where you can get bad cholesterol. And that's out of animal and animal byproducts. The animals make cholesterol. You and I make cholesterol.
Well, we don't need to consume any cholesterol because we make all the
cholesterol. We make all the cholesterol that we need.
So what is the diet that you recommend to your patients from a health perspective and why?
Well, let me just back for a minute because mm-hmm. I don't see patients anymore.
Okay.
So we should know that. Mm-hmm. But the diet, the live it, I recommend. I don't like the word diet because the word diet has the first three letters are die, D-I-E. So the live it, the thing I recommend for people to have the best life is a whole food plant-based diet.
So that
and it does not matter whether you're sick or not sick, whether you're suffering from a cancer or not, but I think that from what I understand today, I would have to say that the whole food plant-based way of eating, or the live it, is the best way to eat.
So it's whole foods, no animal products, no eggs, no dairy, no fish or chicken.
When I say whole food plant-based, mm-hmm. that means if it's not a plant, mm-hmm. if it didn't grow out of the ground, that's not what I'm recommending. So if it walks, hops, crawls, flies, swims, slithers, got eyes, a mom and a daddy, that's not on the menu.
Can you tell me, first, what is the role of diet in erectile dysfunction?
Oh, there's a huge role. The penis has a lot of those endothelial cells, and the penis depends on those cells in order to function properly, to let blood in and keep it in to create the erection. The damage to the endothelial cells just doesn't happen in the blood vessels lining the heart. It actually happens also in those blood cells or those sinusoids lining inside the penis. And when they're damaged, then it can't expand, it can't keep that blood where it needs to be, and therefore the man doesn't have an erection. It is absolutely a critical part of the problem of erectile dysfunction.
Okay. So what kind of diet? Would the same kind of diet,
vegan
diet?
I think there's just a way of, there's
everyone.
One way.
Mm-hmm.
See, this is the beauty of a whole food plant-based way of eating. You don't need a certain one for this and a certain one for that. That's garbage. If you just eat the right foods, you'll have the right results.